Hello guys, it's Tank Nut Dave, and we have very exclusive access today. We are actually inside Bovington Tank Museum's new conservation centre. Behind us are over 100 military vehicles in various different states of restoration. These vehicles span about 70 years of military history and come from all over the world, different periods of armoured warfare. There are vehicles here that have been donated, there are prototypes that the public have never ever seen before that are inside this building, and we're going to walk you around and show you some of these vehicles. Hi guys, it's Tank Nut Dave. I am here with the British Army Chieftain. This is probably the first principal main battle tank that was ever produced in the world. Not only that, it had a gun which many other countries are still trying to achieve, and that is what we refer to the calibre length. Now, the very first thing that made Chieftain distinctive was the fact that the driver's position, which is to my right here, had a reclining chair, a bit like an Easy Boy. And what that meant was rather than the driver sitting upright, he could lay down. And this in turn would reduce the height of the tank's hull. Now, of course, the other exciting part about it, as I said, was a calibre length 55 main gun. Now, France tried to say with Leclerc that they had the biggest gun in NATO. It was complete and utter rubbish. The British had done it with the Chieftain many years before. As I said, this is calibre length 55. What does calibre length mean? Well, you have the bore at the front of the gun where the round comes out. This is 120mm. And then you have calibre length. You take the bore and stack it along the end of the gun. By increasing the length of the gun, that means that the round has a greater distance to travel. And it also means that the energy released from the combustible case charge can build up, thus pushing the round out harder, which means it has a greater punch when it hits a target. It can normally fire a lot longer than a shorter barrel main gun be able to do. And of course, the Challenger, this gun was used on the Challenger 1, which holds the world record for the longest tank-to-tank kill engagement in history. If you want to come down to Bovington Tank Museum, look at the bottom of the video. There is a link for Bovington Tank Museum. The public gallery here, as you can hear, is open during the daytime at certain points. Again, the timetables are all on Bovington Tank Museum's website. And I would like to thank Bovington Tank Museum Director for giving us this exclusive access. If you too are a tank nut and you love military vehicles, then please click on the screen to like us on Facebook to follow our interesting stuff. Thanks a lot.